You gonna jump down, turn around, pick a pail of cotton. Gonna jump down, turn around, pick a pail of day. Gonna jump down, turn around, pick a pail of cotton. Gonna jump down, turn around, pick a pail of day. Gonna jump down. Gonna jump down, pick a pail of day. Gonna jump down. Gonna jump down, pick a pail of day. Gonna jump down, pick a pail of cotton. Pick a pail of day. Gonna jump. You gon' pick a pail of day, gonna You gonna jump down, turn around, pick a pail of cotton. Gonna jump down, turn around, pick a pail of day. Gonna jump down, turn around, pick a pail of cotton. Gonna jump down, turn around, pick a pail of day. Gonna jump down. You gonna jump down, pick a pail of day. Gonna jump down. You gonna jump down, pick a pail of day. Gonna jump down. You gonna jump down, pick a pail of day. Gonna jump down. You gon' jump down, pick a bale of day, you gon' jump down, pick a bale of cotton, pick a bale of day, you gon' jump, you gon' jump, you gon' pick a bale of day, you gon'
Hello again, and I hope you've been having a really raucous, whispery, shouty evening. Hey guys, can we make sure that
it's good now?
Background noise. Sorry about that. I just want to make sure everyone can hear us as clearly as possible. So Spaces would like to thank our 2020 annual benefit sponsors again: James Cohen Gallery, the Beyer Family Fund, Fred and Laura Ruth Bidwell, the Cleveland Clinic Art and Design Institute, Jessica Silverman, Harriet Warm and Dick Blum, John C. Williams, AIA, Ben Ruby Gallery, M. Gentile Studios, Shannon B. McHugh, Mocha Cleveland, Nuisance Projects, Robert Roth, Steve Shane, Woodley International Art Handler, Astoria, Big Mouth Donut, Black Valve Media, Blue Point Grill, Cleveland Institute of Art, Diva D. Cycling, Jukebox, Larder Delicatessen and Bakery, Mallorca, Ninja City, Pope L Studio, Print Camp, Super Electric, Pinball Parlor, Veda Printing, Long Face, Bars Bars, Lauren Herzog Bauman, Ephraim Nehemiah, Angelica Pozo, Sarah Rose Sharp, Tyler Shaw, and Soma T for all of their support. Spaces' 2020 Annual Benefit Committee includes Peter Brooks, Steve Sensula, Sam Hubisch, Deidre McPherson, Ellen Rudolph, and Leticia Wilson. As many of you already know, Spaces temporarily refocused our second year of the Satellite Fund grant program to serve artists affected by the current pandemic and economic crisis. The Satellite Fund, administered by Spaces through a regional regranting program of the Andy Warhol Foundation for the Visual Arts, awarded project-based grants of $6,000 each. Oh, I'm gonna remove my mask because there's nobody around me, so. Awarded project-based grants of $6,000 each to 10 artists' projects in 2019. Those artists are busy completing their projects now. For 2020, the Warhol Foundation authorized its re-granting partners, including Spaces, to reallocate our grants to administer emergency relief for our communities. With that opportunity, we were able to approach other funders and raise even more dollars for distribution to artists locally. We owe a huge debt of gratitude to the Warhol Foundation, the Cleveland Foundation, Takayama Fund at the Cleveland Foundation, and individual donors Susan E. Murray and Donald E. Harvey. Thanks to their support, Spaces awarded 126 emergency relief grants through the Satellite Fund Emergency Relief Program. The emergency relief grants supported artists who had been significantly impacted by the current pandemic and economic crisis. We provided unrestricted funding and grants of up to $1,000 to be used for living expenses, medical bills, or other basic needs. Of those awarded, our 20,000 reported risk factors included underlying conditions. Awarded artists worked in a range of mediums, from drawing, painting, and sculpture to performance, graphic design, and even food styling. I briefly want to introduce some of the Urgent Art Fund projects that will be coming from our 2019 Satellite Fund recipients, including Morning of Black Star, whose five-episode live music docu-series follows the story of the Afrofuturist Music Collective at Morning of Black Star. Follow them on Instagram as they prepare their sixth studio album. And that is due to be released November 11th, 2020. Soursop Stories is working on ancestral transitions, modern acquisitions. These are the dances of Caribbean mothers, fathers, Grammys, and pappies. These steps, which have been typically done under the Caribbean sun, have been transported to the shores of Lake Erie. How does one preserve the sanctity of these movements while adjusting to a new reality? This work is an ode to the process of self-discovery and what it means to be Caribbean women in the Midwest. December 2020, so that will be coming up soon as well. Anna Tararova, whose project Empress Editions received an Urgent Art Fund Award. Empress Editions will publish and produce five risograph and screen-printed artist books of artists by color that reside in Cuyahoga County, and that is an ongoing project. Uno Lady, whose project Grounded and whose osmosis you've seen throughout the run of our program, is presenting Grounded, an ambient experimental film series and audio-visual installation based on meditation. And our fifth Urgent Art Fund artist recipient is Amanda King, whose project, My God is Anti-Racist, is a multi-layered, multimedia meditation on God as the embodiment of anti-racism. And that date is to be announced as well. Corey Slauson and Christina Lindhout, whose 2019 satellite-funded project Feast, a ballet, will be performed online on November 27th, 2020. One of our Satellite Fund Emergency Relief Grant recipients included our second 2020 annual benefit honoree, Stephen Bivens, who, as an artist, as a photographer, and as a dedicated and passionate educator, impacted many lives throughout our region. He was a very beloved person in our community, and though I never had a chance to meet him, I have had a chance to meet his wonderful wife, Jennifer Bivens, who really has just been such a wonderful human being to get to know in my time here in Cuyahoga County. So without further ado, we will start off this segment presenting some of our Urgent Art Fund and Satellite Fund Emergency Relief Grant Program recipients who have prepared short videos, and then we will lead into a segment in honor of our 2020 annual benefit honoree, Stephen Bivens. Thank you so much, and I hope you enjoy.
It's actually kind of the right
time
to do it.
So I received from Spaces Gallery, Satellite Fund Emergency Relief Grant. And I have to say, boy, when did that happen? I would say that's probably, I mean, that was probably June, July, that I received that Spaces Emergency Art Fund grant. And, I mean, it definitely helped, you know. Kept us in firewood all through the summer. Kept us in firewood all through the summer into the winter. Well, the fall, anyway. I was able to purchase some photographic film, 100 speed Kodak. I'm interested to see how that turns out. And, you know, it felt good to be redeemed and to earn a grant as opposed to, say, a gig or a prize. Because it's just a do-your-thing kind of money, you know? It's not... What is a grant?
Not a paycheck.
What is a grant? It's not a paycheck for work done, and it's not money within expectation that you produce something. It's just like a, hey, do your thing. And that's nice. It's nice to be able to make work. It's nice to exist without the expectation that you produce something. It's nice to be recognized for the work that you've done without the expectation that you produce new work. And it's nice to feel like somebody wants you to keep on living. So I want to thank Spaces Gallery for that. And hopefully I can afford another Rick, and maybe even a Cord next time. Thanks very much. Oh, I'm Rustin McCann. I forgot to say I was Rustin McCann. All right, so I'm Rustin McCann, and I received a... Is it good? Was all that good? Is there something in there?
Yeah. I think it's funny.
I'm Rustin McCann, and I want to say thank you to Spaces Gallery for the emergency grant. Spaces Emergency Relief Fund. Spaces Emergency Relief Fund. Boy. Well, let's just say it helped me out in a tough time. Thanks very much. I'm Rustin McCann. Back to your Saturday morning cartoons.
Hello, my name is Anna Tararova. I run Empress Editions, a risograph and screen printing press in Cleveland. Empress Editions is a part of Imprint Arts Collective, a DIY arts community in the Cadell neighborhood. I am a recipient of the 2020 Spaces Urgent Grant. Through this grant, Empress Editions will publish artist books by 5 artists of color in Cuyahoga County. The artists were selected through an open call. It was juried by myself and Eric Von Haynes of Flatland Press in Chicago. These books will be risograph printed by me and bound by Outlandish Press. Risograph printing is a spot color-based printing process which combines the best of digital and traditional print. Created for high-volume, inexpensive duplicating, it has been adapted by artists to produce beautiful and unique spot color-based works. The first book is by Leila Khoury, titled The Soulful Body, The Immigration and Placemaking of Arabs in Detroit. It chronicles the history, built environment, social and cultural support networks within Detroit's Arab American community. Arful Pajurilaga is working on a book of photographs from the time he was living in a room with no windows in Chicago. He wants to convey the experience of displacement, isolation, and loneliness. Bianca Field's book will consist of risograph-printed reproductions of her paintings and drawings. Bianca's work is colorful, crazy, and fun, with plenty of texture and visible brush strokes. It's a fun challenge to translate through a spot color printing process. Kenyatta Crisp's photo book, titled Divine, is a collection of portraits of Black women he has a close relationship with, celebrating their strength and beauty. Amber Ford's book is part of an ongoing series titled Results May Vary, which is a multimedia project offering glimpses into the world of black hair. In the future, I plan to find further funding for this project and continue to publish artwork and books by local artists of color.
Hello, my name is Julie Schenkelberg. I received one of the emergency relief grants from the Spaces Satellite Fund. I'm an artist that makes sculpture, site-specific installation, and drawings. I was so grateful to receive and to be included in, as one of the recipients of this funding. It helped me to carry on my practice through the COVID-19 crisis. In March, I was on a residency in upstate New York at Yaddo. I had been longing to have this residency for many years and was finally awarded. It was interrupted, and I came back to Cleveland, where I was born, and stayed with my family. I needed help from my family, and my family needed help from me. My practice had been based in Detroit the last few years, so I decided to come back here in March. But many of my shows and projects were canceled. Money from these projects was delayed, put off several years. But there was one project that went forward, and that was the one that took place in September and October of this year. The gallery that I show with in Manhattan wanted to do my fifth solo show. They remained open. So this summer here in Cleveland, I had to find a studio space, materials, and also have some money left over for transportation of my work to New York City. I was able to do that through this grant. My work is based in the Midwest. It tells the story of the past, the industry, what can be done to the rebirth and changing of art and our community. Many of my works have been shown in Europe, site-specific and small sculptures. So coming back to Cleveland has been a wonderful blessing. And my work has been shown in Detroit, Grand Rapids, Pittsburgh, Italy, New York City. So it feels great to be here in the community, to be included by Spaces, and to be supported by my hometown. I really appreciate the philanthropy behind this grant and in Cleveland, and look forward to becoming more a part of this community and see how it begins to enrich my work even more with the story of our city and surroundings. Thank you so much.
Hi Spaces, I'm Susie Frazier, and I cannot tell you how grateful I am for the Satellite Fund Emergency Relief Grant. Your funds came at a critical time back in April when a lot of things were uncertain, and I took it as an act of faith that you believed in me as one of the more veteran artists here in this city and also believed in what I'm capable of. So I took your money and I leveraged it to actually attract more. And I spent the last 4 months building a new technology that is not only going to help my business, but hundreds of other arts-based businesses in our region. So I've attached a video to this video to give you a sense of what I've been up to. And I just want you to know how much I appreciate everything you guys do. Thank you, Spaces.
Artists, makers, and galleries are part of a community that provides this region its living cultural identity. We rely on each other and the events we create to help our businesses thrive. In the absence of activities where large crowds are permitted, we're adapting in new ways so we can engage better with our customers. Because we know people want to shop local in Northeast Ohio. They want to keep their money in the local economy, and they want to support those entrepreneurs who they've grown to love at all those art walks and maker events around town. Up until now, they just didn't have a universal way to find us all online. I created the MakerTown app because I saw the need to aggregate all of the local creative businesses and maker events into one interactive directory. we needed to make it much easier for people to find all the artists and businesses here, and with a simple click, go to all of our existing websites where they can shop with us online. MakerTown isn't another shopping platform. It's more like a concierge that gets you to those platforms where my friends and I are sharing our creations with the world.
I'm Nina Morin, a recipient of a Spaces Pandemic Emergency Relief Grant. Thank you so much. I put it to really good use. And thank you for all your support through the years, and congratulations to the other grant winners. Madam, sirs, ladies and gents, to you, and to you, I present my wondrous rare box with its story of origins from a place I know not. I met this beauty just as you will today. I peeped and I gasped, but before turning away, responsibility called from my foremost lobe to protect it and direct it around the globe and share it with those I meet in this exact way. Brave souls such as you and you and you who are curious and willing to play. Feel it, smell it, taste it. What? No! Just peep for now. You, sir, may step right up. Consider your body. Think of all the places your body has been. In the womb for a watery ride, and then, for a time too short or too long, in anxious and overwhelmed caregiver's arms. Perhaps in a transport, or a carriage, or swing, through a host of institutions, and on patches of green, your body. I am right, am I not? Take this moment to consider the lot. Your body, in the sun and under stars, in restaurants, in dance halls, perhaps even in bars. Your body has been moving about. Your funny little walk as you go in and out, your delightful gums flapping, your pointy fingers snapping, your evil little laughter, your sincere smile after, your hips, how they and move and sway. Each morning you wake to another day of your eyes seeing, your nose picking up what it can, your ears tracking, your taste bumps smacking, your feelers oohing and knowing and ahing and yearning, and all the while your senses experiencing, burning with life, and you awash in sensation. Would that you could remember you are the glorious accumulation of all the things your body has been through. Don't let your thoughts trick your mind to organize a small idea of you in the world, separate and other. No. You are connected and continuous with your mother nature and all your friends. Here, there, and everywhere, I swear, consider your body. It's lovely, isn't it? ones. I am called. I don't quite know the reason. I trusted we would meet today, and so again another season. But before you go, remember this. We have knowledge, words, theories, and thoughts. But without the warmth of our fellow animals, without the hum and churn of nature, without feeling, smelling, tasting, hearing, touching, breathing each other, we are lost.
Late 2015, early 2016, I had a batch of songs that I had messed with. And
I started working with Ari Washington, and we were childhood friends, went to high school together, and were in each other's careers when I was still in Cleveland as a teenager, but then started to make music together. And Morning of Black Star was actually born from us wanting to get back together and make something new.
A good friend of mine who, her daughter's my goddaughter, dates this guy.
And so she was telling him that, you know, my boyfriend can sing. And if you know Rafiq, he was like, oh, really?
You know, I was like, hey man, I got some songs, you wanna go to the studio? And I kinda just left it alone. I kinda forgot I told him. And he came back, double back, and told me, yo, man, hey, man, you know. And he told me later that that wasn't something that he would do. If somebody brings something up to him and they don't bring it back up again, he's not gonna bring it up. But this time,
thinking to myself, don't be so terminally me. Like, usually I just wouldn't bring it up. Whatever. As he didn't bring it up, I'm not bringing it up. So I said, James, stop being you. So I said, hey, man, what's up with that project? He looked at me. He's like,
and I was like, oh man, that's crazy, because like I got a session up
at this location where he'd be working on some stuff. So I walk into this room, into this house actually, and there are 15 people milling around, and I only knew Rafiq, and so I was just kind of sitting there, and I thought it was just going to be a meet and greet and kind of get, you know, indoctrinated into what happens in the music thing, you know.
And so we got together and he had this music.
And so he's doing all these beats. He's just making these beats and he's playing them. And then this one pretty lady takes papers from him.
And I was like, I don't sing other people's lyrics. He was like, well, just, you know, it's poetry. And I'm like, cool.
And, you know, starts reading them. And then in the moment, she's like, okay, I think I got it. I think I got it. And steps up to the mic and just starts singing. And it's a banger. I'm like, okay, these are heat rocks. This is sweet. So I'm sitting there like, okay, this is nice. Then all of a sudden he says, okay, she's done. You're up. So I'm like, what do you mean I'm up?
And then I be like, go.
Hands me a sheet of paper and says, these are the lyrics. This is the beat. See what you can do.
And that's what we would do.
I've been feeling Run away. I wanted to show everybody this image of Stephen Bivens, and this was one of the first occasions that I really got to know him. And it's a piece that he did of a self-portrait that was for the Artist Trust of Cuyahoga County. I love this piece. I was so excited to see it. I really thought it sort of caught the character of him. He was such a beautiful person, and I'm really thrilled that I have had the opportunity to get to know him as much as I did, and his beautiful wife, Jennifer. And it's been incredible to not only show his work at the gallery and to get to know him through all of the other shows and moments that I've gotten to connect with him. And he will certainly be missed by me. And I think he was much loved by this community.
I remember the first time I met Stephen, you might have met him before, but was where was the pizza place? Remember
right.
We met Bridget and
right. So Bridget suggested that we speak with Stephen about working with students.
Yes.
So, yeah. Yeah.
And we went to Scotty's Pizza.
Yes. In the neighborhood, of
yes,
course.
Yes, in Collingwood.
So that was almost 3 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
2017. You know, he was in the neighborhood a lot. In fact, I remember seeing his photographs from the neighborhood in Facebook before I met him.
Right.
So he would photograph all the arts organizations and the restaurants. Or
yeah. It's interesting, like the sort of voyeuristic nature of photography in general. You know, the like being present but not being present. Stephen's personality is kind of the perfect profile for being in a room and being able to quietly observe
right.
without sort of obstructing what was happening. You
right.
know, I mean, that's the thing I think about him all the time for such a large, you know, imposing figure.
Right.
He had this, like, really quiet, sort of small, gentle
demeanor.
Way. He's just a lovely person. And I think that translated into his art practice, you know, of being able to observe in that quiet way. It was interesting in the beginning of these talks about doing this project for the library, one of the things that was on the table was not a million pictures of the Terminal Tower. And when this entered the equation, Stephen's piece with the Terminal Tower included in this and this skate, it changed the conversation. Now this photo of the Terminal Tower, yes, we can have.
Right, his unique perspective.
His unique perspective, which is gentle and quiet and almost magical.
So this one of Euclid Beach Arena is one of Stephen's works that was included in this. We, as far as curating it, right away were drawn to it because of the color, but also because it looks like it could be in Florida or somewhere else, and here it's Cleveland. We really liked that. It's such a great family photo.
Part of the premise was to sort of change the way Cleveland had been documented. And one of the things that the photographers who were chosen to do this work, especially Stephen, were chosen because of their ability to see and to put the people of Cleveland into this narrative. You know, there's something about that quiet observation that allows a person to see beyond what the rest of us are seeing or privileging or think is important.
Right.
And I can see some of it in the influence of some of it in the work of the young artists who were at the print, especially when he was teaching a lot, even in the instant photo.
He was pretty dedicated to those kids. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. The Stephen Bibbins Memorial Fund was brought to us by Jennifer. At the same time that some of our board members were calling me and saying, we really have to do something to memorialize Stephen. And it'll provide students with funding once we get all the details ironed out. But we're very excited to see, moving forward, how we can make sure that students that need funding or materials will be able to obtain them.
Hi, I'm Valerie Grossman of Brick Ceramic and Design Studio. Stephen was the most generous person I've ever met. He was a great friend, and he loved his community. Stephen would often come over and photograph what was happening in the studio. He was a great father, husband, and really a craftsman with how he really practiced and honed in his craft for photography. He just had such a skill for snapping at just the right moment. So we became great friends, and it allowed for me to have some really fun photo shoots with Stephen. And he was just such a kind person. He loved my puppy Lily, and Lily loved him, and she really is sort of a nervous dog, and she didn't take to everyone, but she loved Stephen. Photography skills, but experiencing this photo shoot with him was so magical. It just made me feel so strong and beautiful. Both Stephen and Jen have been such great support for my studio, and I really think that they are part of the glue that held our district together. I mean, Biv was always up and down the street, and you can see his impact on us as well as Cleveland's art community, and he's just gone too soon.
My name's Melinda Placco, and I had the pleasure of working with Steve Bivens at the Print Room. We shared a classroom together for the last couple of years. A couple of our students shared a written tribute that I'd like to read. This one is by Destiny Cruz. When I hear your name, a smile spreads across my face. You were the first person to ask me for an interpretation of my art. Without criticism, you listened as a new nervous photographer explained the best she could. You held a smile the entire time. You showed your support by purchasing a piece. This brought me to tears. Your act of kindness made me feel like I could achieve anything. You appeared at every show us kids had. I remember your deep but gentle tone, always checking in on me and my peers. Your question, "Do you photograph every day?" made me examine my dedication to photography and eventually find it to be my passion. Our interaction, your support, and presence touched my soul as it did many others. Thank you, Bev. That's Destiny Cruz. Here's another written by Gabby Murray. Like many other photographers, my first experience with the Print Room was meeting Bev. He was one of those people who always knew what to say in any situation you needed a person to talk to. Biv was one of my favorite people to work with on any photo project because he always gave me a new perspective through the lens in life. Biv was gentle, loving, and treated everyone, young or old, as if they were one of his own children. Biv guided me in many new directions with nothing but love and support. I was so lucky to know such a beautiful person. And that's by Gabby Murray. Biv had such a great quiet encouragement that he brought with him anywhere he walked. And his students really knew that very well. He wanted them to do their best work, and he wanted to offer them a calm and supportive environment. There was one day we were talking over lesson plans, and I asked him what he thought the kids would, you know, be best suited to learning that day, what he felt was important to offer them that day. And he said he just wants to offer them a relaxed atmosphere, just a chill atmosphere. And that's what we did. Biv was also one of the few who always showed up, 100%. He was there. I was teaching a class in his neighborhood, and he came in just to see what we were up to. He ended up walking with us out to the beach and shooting photographs and interacting with the students and asking them about the work that they were making. He was one of the few who really showed up. Thanks for being there for all of us, Steve. Miss you.
Hi, I'm Jennifer Bivens, and I am delighted to be here this evening as part of the Spaces event, and even more so honored that Spaces has chosen to take some time to recognize Steven's life, his legacy, his commitment to the arts community of Cleveland, his professional work, his commitment to teaching students photography and training up the next generation of artists. Steven was thrilled to be a recipient of the Emergency Fund grant. The pandemic really did impact his work dramatically. He went from teaching on a daily basis, having multiple professional opportunities ahead of him, to nothing. And I know he is no different than any of the other artists in our community. So the Emergency Fund grant was something that he felt very strongly about, and he certainly needed as a professional artist. He passed away just several days, literally, after receiving the grant. And during that time, I had been talking with the Cleveland Print Room, and we had decided that we wanted to form a memorial fund to allow them to continue their work, reaching young people and teaching them photography, providing them access to a darkroom, all of the amazing things they do that Stephen felt so strongly about. And so I contacted Spaces and asked them if they would be willing to allow me to gift Stephen's grant towards the launch of this memorial fund. And they graciously agreed. And I was delighted to be able to do that and continue to put those funds to good use moving forward for many, many years to come, I'm sure. You have heard from other artists in the community about Stephen's life, about his work, about his friendship, about his character. And we are going to close this time honoring him and remembering him with a video of Stephen. This video was created by our dear friend Travis as part of his application to the Cleveland Arts Prize process several years ago. And this video just gives a wonderful snapshot of who Stephen was. Just to hear his voice again will just bring you such joy for those of you who knew him and spent time with him. He closes this video saying, "I have so much more left to do." Those are his closing words in the video you're about to see. And I trust that there are things that were spoken by other artists leading up to this moment here. You will hear things that Stephen speaks of in the video that follows. And he really does have so much more left to do. And now what he has left to do is in our hands. So if there's an element of Stephen's character that you find of great value, if there's an element of his commitment to his work, to teaching young people, to being present in the arts community, to being a friend, to being a colleague, whatever those elements of who Stephen was and what his life brought to you, what it brought to me, he does still have so much more left to do. And now he's going to do that through us and through our commitment and ability to continue his legacy and to continue to communicate the things that he valued, to continue to pour into young people and bring up the next generation of artists, to continue to create work that speaks of our city, that speaks of ourselves, that challenges others as they look at it. And so, you know, sometimes you may need to whisper. And I think those of you who know Stephen knew he was a very quiet, reserved gentleman. And he did a lot of whispering. Sometimes you need to shout. And there were times when Stephen did shout. He shouted primarily through his work. And this image behind me is actually a beautiful print that Liz Moggins gifted me shortly after Stephen passed away. She had created it several years ago. She'd had it. We talked about it. She said, "Stephen, I'm going to get this to you. I created this monoprint. It's so cool, and I want you to have it." But this print says two things. It says, "Proud to be from Collinwood." Very true. Stephen was very proud to call Collinwood home. And he spoke through his pictures. And that is true. He lived through his pictures, through his photographs. And so it is now up to us to continue to carry on Stephen's legacy, his values, his commitment to the arts and to other things, and to just continue to live his life and his principles, because he really does have so much more left to do, and now it's up to us to carry on that legacy. Thank you so much for the opportunity to visit with you this evening. Thank you so much for your commitment to the arts and for all that Spaces is doing and for all that other artists within the community are doing. I'm so grateful and so appreciative of your friendship, of your care, many of you have reached out to me, and the Cleveland community is just so beautiful and so generous and so loving, and I am grateful for that. Thank you very much. Enjoy your evening, and I trust the video that follows will speak to you and challenge you, because Stephen really does have so much more left to do, and it's now up to us to help him do it.
Hi, my name is Stephen Bivens. I'm 50 years old, and I'm a photographer who loves Cleveland. The life that I see around me is what I want to capture. Pure moments of just people going about their life in an everyday way. And that starts right here in my neighborhood. Photography offers me the freedom to see the world as I want to see it. I was not a photographer when I came to Cleveland. I dabbled a little bit, but it was a lot of just as a hobbyist. When I came to Cleveland and saw the incredible artists here, it empowered me and gave me motivation to become a photographer. And I studied and I practiced and I went to workshops and I did it all. I read millions of books on photography to be on the level with some of the guys here that I met. And they motivate me to get better. I love shooting film because it slows me down. It tells my story differently than digital because you have to know your craft well enough to know that you have that picture before I click that shutter. Type of photography I do is a lot of street photography. Concert photography, portraits, people, architecture. I just love to capture the culture of the city I'm in. One of the projects I'm working on now is my 52 Muses. I'm gonna take 52 portraits of women who inspire me or uplift me in a certain way. I have four sisters, I'm the only boy. So I always looked up to my big sisters. With my wife, I started taking portraits of her to practice with. And I really wanted to go farther and take pictures of people that inspire me. I'm also teaching photography to kids, that next generation. They have questions that I haven't thought about in years. And I have to think about those questions, and I'll usually go back and try it after the class, just to make sure, you know, they keep me on my P's and Q's. And it's a learning experience for me. I have a lot more to learn here in Cleveland. At this point in my life, I'm just getting started. I got so much more to do.